Hello everyone, myself Rohan Pardle, student of SAS Institute of Management Studies, pursuing MBA in Operational Management. Today I am here to discuss a topic called Service Inventory Management, which comes under the subject called Service Inventory Management. Let's discuss Service Inventory Management here. Here are the some outline of Service Inventory Management. They are like an element of inventory management, inventory and supply chain management, inventory control system, economic order quantity model, reorder point, and classification of inventory ABC and VED. What is inventory? A physical resources that our firms hold in stock with the intent of selling it or transfer to it into a more valuable states. That's called inventory management. The purpose of inventory management, why we are doing inventory? The answer is how many units to be ordered, when to order, how much discount we will get. This comes under when we think purpose of inventory management. Types of inventory: raw material, purchase part and supply, finished goods, work in progress, item being transported, tools and equipments. Nature of inventories: raw material, the basic input that are covered into the finished product through the manufacturing process. Second one is work in progress, semi-manufactured products that need some more work before they become finished goods for sales. Finished goods, completely manufactured product ready for sale. Supplies, office and plant material not directly entered into the production but are necessary for the production process and do not involve significant investment. Inventory and supply chain management. Bullwhip effects, it's a demand information is restored at the move away from the end user customer. High safety stock inventories are stored by the compensate. Seasonal or cyclical demand, sales of umbrella dominate sales in weekends. These are the good example of seasonal and cyclical demand. Inventory provides independence for vendors taking advantage of price discount. Inventory provide independence between states and avoid work stoppage, work in progress in inventories. Two forms of demand, dependent and independent. Dependent demand is like demand for any item used produced for final product. Tires stored in a plant are example of dependent demand item because the sales of tire is totally dependent upon the automobile sector and the sales of automobile sector. Another one is independent demand. Demand for item used by the external customer, car, computer, house are example of independent demand inventory. Inventory and quality management. Customer usually perceives quality services as available of goods when they want them. Inventory must be sufficient to provide high quality customer service. Inventory cost. To calculate the inventory cost, we have to go through with the various costs. They are like carrying cost. Carrying cost is nothing but it's the cost of holding an item in inventory. Second one, ordering cost, the cost of replenishing inventory. Third one is shortage cost. It's a temporary or permanent loss of sales when demand cannot be met. Inventory control system, continuous system, fixed order quantity. Under this, constant amount of order when inventory declines to predetermined level. Second one is periodical system, fixed time period, order placed for a variable amount after a fixed passage of time. Next one is economic order quantity model, which also known as EOQ. It's when we want to determine the optimum number of units to order so that we can minimize the total cost associated with the purchase, delivery and the shortage of product. Basic EQO model, production quantity model. Assumption of basic EOQ model. Demand is known, constant and independent. Lead time is known and constant. Order quantity received and instantaneous and complete. No shortage is allowed. In this slide, you can see the inventory order cycle, how we cycle the inventory when it comes to order the next our product. You can see that order quantity resemble as a Q and reorder point shows denoted as R. And the graph shows the demand rates, lead time, order placed, order received. Here's the formula of EOQ cost model. C stands for cost of placing order, CC stands for annual per unit carrying cost, D stands for annual demand and order, Q stands for order quantity. So by this we can get the annual order cost, annual carrying cost and total total cost. This is the graph which resembles annual cost, minimum total cost, carrying cost, ordering cost. So the point where the slope meets is equal to zero. This is the our EOQ. Next one is production quantity model. An inventory system in which the order is received gradually as inventory is simulated being depleted, as known as non-instantaneous receipt model, now replaced not at once. Assumption Q is a received all that at once is relaxed. P stands for daily rate at which an order is received over the time, or the production rate. D denotes the daily rate at which the inventory is demanded. This is the formula which defines how the production model quantity works. P stands for the production rate, maximum inventory level is denoted by the Q, and you can see that there are certain formulas.